Welcome to Royal's Education. I am Yashwant Singh, and today I am going to talk about Indo-Pak relation, the complete story. So this is a story which is very much talked about on the world panorama. So let us see how is and how was the Indo-Pak relations. Pak was created as part of two-nation theory in 1947. It was carved out of India, expecting JNK to merge with Pakistan with 65% Muslim population. It sent in irregulars for invasion. Then Maharaja Hari Singh signed instrument of accession on 26 October 1947. Indian army dispatched and halted the advance of Pak. Then Kashmir issue referred to Security Council, which passed following resolution in 1949. First, ceasefire between Indian and Pak forces. Second, withdrawal of Pak forces from occupied territory. Third, India to reduce forces in JNK and conduct plebiscite. Then UNTPS was positioned to monitor ceasefire, and there was no withdrawal by Pak, so there was no plebiscite. Then in 1957, Kashmir was formally incorporated into the Indian Union. It was granted a special status under Article 370 of India's Constitution, which ensures, among other things, that non-Kashmiri Indians cannot buy property there. Then it came April 1965, when Pak intrusion in Run of Kutch and attack on India in September resulted in 22-day war. Then USSR brokered ceasefire. Tashkent Declaration was signed between PM Lal Bahadur Shastri and General Yahya Khan. Then it came 1971. There was denial of prime ministership to Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, resulted in uprising in East Pak and consequent liberation of Bangladesh on 16 December 1971 and 95,000 Pak prisoners of war. Then it came 1972. So there was a similar agreement between Indira Gandhi and Zulfikar Ali Bhutto. The points were as under: all disputes to be solved bilaterally. Second, all prisoners of war to be returned. Third, position to be marked and maps exchanged showing location of forces. Here in this slide, you can see that this is the official map of the Indian government. Here you can see that this part, which is in the east of the JNK, means it is a part of the JNK only, is illegally occupied by China. Then you see here, there is a Karakoram Pass. Then this is also completely the part of the JNK, which is ours. But this is actually the Pakistan occupied Kashmir, which it occupied in 1947. Here you see it's Kargil. This is Jammu and Kashmir, the Leh portion. This is Jammu. This portion which you see that there is a blank over here. Actually, this is the point of NJ 9842, which was taken by Indian government, since there was means there are no place that it can deploy forces over there. So the Pakistan objected to it. We are going to see it later. So in 1984, LOC was not marked beyond, as I already told you, LOC was not marked beyond NJ 9842. Indian forces occupied Solotur Reach in Siachen, which Pak objected. Then Siachen, highest battlefield on earth, was created. We dominate Pak positions, spent 4 crores a day, and there is a high physical casualties. Temperature goes down to minus 30 to minus 50 degrees centigrade. Thereafter, it came the militancy in JNK since 1989, with large-scale infiltration of foreign fighters, groups which are active, JKLF, HM, HUM, LET, and JEM. Thereafter, in 1999, there was Kargil. Actually, Pak occupied Indian position vacated during winter, resulting in armed conflict. Thereafter, it came 13 December 2001. There was a parliament attack and consequent mob of army. Operation Parakram was held. Operations called off due to US pressure. Then it came 2002. There was election in JNK. PDP plus Congress government was formed. In 2003, CBMs, Lahore Bus, Samjhota Express. Then recall stop at embassies, restoration of flights, ceasefire on LOC in November 2003. But the things took a very ugly turn when it came 2014. India's relationship with Pakistan's were at lowest. By the beginning of 2016, it was abundantly clear that the Pakistan was not interested in the resumption of dialogue and continued to promote and support cross-border terrorism to harm India. Limits were crossed when the Pathankot airbase was attacked on 2nd Jan 2016. There was a further setback to relations when 18 soldiers of Indian Army were killed in a terrorist attack in September 2016 in Uri, the Baramulla district of JNK. In befitting response, India carried out a successful surgical strike on terrorist camps in the Pak-occupied Kashmir across the line of control within a week of Uri attack. Then, Pak staged the Pulwama attack, killing 40 CRPF jawans in February 2019, and it was promptly retaliated by an air strike by the Indian Air Force on the terrorist training center in Balakot inside the Pakistan. So what's now? The relationship have gone from bad to worse due to Pakistan's feverish attempts to internationalize Kashmir issue after the abrogation of Article 370. These efforts were skillfully thwarted by India's proactive diplomatic offensive, and it has created a great wound in the relationship of India and Pakistan further. So what is the policy of India in this case? India has adopted a firm policy of terror and talks cannot go together, and has made it fully clear that no talks will be held unless there are tangible and verifiable concrete evidence of Pakistan reigning in the state sponsored and supported terrorism which targets against India and stopping interference in Kashmir. So these are all the line of events between India and Pakistan since the Pakistan was created in 1947 till date. So I think that I have cleared everything in the Indo-Pak relation as of now. If you have liked this video, please like and press the bell icon, share and subscribe. Thank you.